Welcome, and thank you for coming. My name is Ejel Khan. I'm the coordinator of the Muslim LGBT Network in the UK. Although I'm born and bred in this country, I travelled all the way from Luton and Bedfordshire today to be with you. The reason why I came is because our organisation has solidarity across the Muslim world, and we're going to publicise this on social media across all our platforms. We want the world to know, and not just the British people, the Muslim world as well, across the world to know what's happening. I've been a human rights activist for a quarter century now, and I wanted to publicise. I've been meaning to come here, but because of the lockdown restrictions, I couldn't. But I have a special dispensation today to travel because this is for political purposes. As you might know, many of you here come here every month, that 1 million people have been detained in camps in Xinjiang. There are approximately 380 camps at the moment which have been detaining Muslims from the Uyghur minority. Mainly, most of them as well, have done nothing wrong. They're innocent civilians. Some have asked for freedom for the East Turkestan people. And that's also a movement that is gaining momentum there. And that's one of the reasons why the Chinese government and building here have opposed what's happening there. This has been the biggest mass detention since World War II. This is akin to the Holocaust in Europe. There's been religious practices have been suppressed by the Chinese government and forced re-education within their indoctrination of for political purposes. There's also been forced sterilization, torture, and forced labor in the camps where they make products for the Western world, products that we consume, such as Nike and so on. I just don't want to single out Nike, but there's many other companies who use the services of these people who are detained against their will and by forced labor. The whole amendment, the whole genocide amendment that this government put through was defeated, unfortunately, in Parliament. And this was a great setback for the cause. We have to understand, not just as a Muslim, I'm speaking to you as a human being and a human rights activist, that all of us, irrespective of what religious background, from what nationality we are, where we're from, we cannot turn a blind eye to this Holocaust happening today in the modern world in the 21st century. This is going on as we speak. And this is being sanctioned by Western countries who are allies of China for monetary reasons, because China is an emerging superpower. And that's the only reason why it's happening. These countries are turning a blind eye. We have to speak out against what's happening, people. And thank you for coming. And let's all condemn the Chinese government, what they're doing. So thank you very much for listening.